Hobbit Hut video. End of week 3, start of week 4. Not a lot going on outside today. The garbage bin has been removed this week, so that's 60 yards of trash and garbage and debris that's been removed. So other than the waste bin being removed, nothing else going on outside. Any garbage that we have now are just stacking up in piles, and we'll get another bin in another week or two as things progress. That's normal coming in the back door. A lot of changes happened this week. As far as the building permit, we have it now. We are now back in the kitchen, as you can see. Big changes here is all the drywall on the exterior walls has been removed, as you can see the pink insulation in the dining room. We built two support walls, one running down the kitchen and one running down the living room. The reason for those support walls is in between the main wall that used to be in there, as you can see the dark line at the very end there between the pink. That was the main load-bearing wall. It's been removed, and the temporary walls on both sides are now carrying the load of the rafters. So let me just go in between the walls here and give a quick rundown. So looking in between the walls, you can see where the wall used to be there. That was the opening between the dining room and the living room. And if you look up here, you can see that the rafters all met on top of that wall. So now what happens is you can see the insulation has been pushed. We pushed back the insulation on both sides. What's going to happen now is we're going to cut a 4-inch wide opening right between those rafters, and that's where that big long beam will slide up into the attic, and then all those rafters will be joined to the beam to carry the load. Once that happens, then the two temporary walls, which you can see there, will be removed. I'm just going to turn totally right around here, and what you see here is the start of the wall of the kitchen that will be there. The fridge will back onto that, as well as a pantry, and above there is what the beam will sit on at this end. That will give support, and then there will be jack posts and beams in the basement to carry that load. I'll go back through the wall here and see the fireplace, and no other changes here. Again, only the exterior drywall has been removed. As far as the bedrooms go, no changes in framing or anything down there. We removed the exterior drywall, like I said, and all the insulation in the wall has been removed, because the newer insulation is much more efficient than the old stuff. As you can see, beams still hanging around here. Down to the basement, lots of changes going on there. As last week, I spent 2 full days down here removing walls and doing some reorganizing of things. And of course, Michelle has been here all day yesterday getting rid of all the junk. So as you can see down here, things are slightly cleaner. All walls have been removed. There's the water softening system, etc. Old oil tank that needs to be removed. I give a long shot here to the full basement. So as you can see, it's totally wide open down here. All these jack posts, the house has been re-straightened. The beam that you see there going the length of the house was up and down up to 1 inch in places. So this week I spent a whole day jacking the house up, straightening out that beam, putting all those posts in there to get it back to a uniform level. And if I wish you could have smelled it down here yesterday, it was really bad. They had cats, and lots of them, and this was I think this was their litter box for their cats were down here. So we sprayed some stuff in here, so we're hoping that it kind of fixes the issue. But poor Michelle, she was down here for about 5 hours yesterday, and it wasn't the best smelling affair. But hopefully we've got most of the problem whipped up. That's it for end of week three. Week four should be pretty good. The beam should be in, patio door should be done, back door should be done. So hopefully next week you'll see a totally different house upstairs. That's all for now. Thanks. Stay tuned.